Well, thank you. It's a treat to be here at this incredibly beautiful camp.
Widespread.
I think globalization is probably like a person.
I don't know.
All right.
Globalization.
Globalization is spreading something to different parts of the world.
Who like really studies like matters around it.
Globalization to me is a process of making a world smaller and closer without losing to each other and the uniqueness of each other.
Well, globalization is when probably when you take something all around the world and you kind of like make it known.
Nice.
When something gets well known around the world.
Okay.
It's the worldwide spread of thoughts and ideas and cultures.
While you were sleeping, we entered globalization 3.0 from the year 2000 to the present. And it's shrinking the world from size small to size tiny and flattening the global economic playing field at the same time. Only what is really new, really exciting, really terrifying about this era of globalization is it's not built around countries. It's not built anymore exclusively around companies. No, what's really new, really exciting, really terrifying, and wholly unprecedented is that this era of globalization is built around individuals. When I say the world is flat, I don't mean we're equal. I mean that we have created a platform, this flat world platform, on which more people can enter every day, more individuals, from which they can share knowledge, work, entertainment, information, business, innovation, and unfortunately also terrorism.
Nestle got its name from Henry Nestle, a Swiss man who created and sold its first product, infant formula. He developed this revolutionary formula in 1866 and within 5 years had expanded sales to Europe, the United States, and New Zealand. Nestle also began diversification with the production of condensed milk and chocolate, two products that it still makes today. After 1905, when it merged with the Anglo-Swiss Condensed Milk Company, Nestle began slowly moving its way across the globe through means of corporate mergers and product diversification. Over the years, it had expanded to places like Australia, China, and the Pacific Islands, all while absorbing new companies and developing new products. Companies like L'Oreal, Jenny Craig, and Buitoni all have been purchased by Nestle at some point in time and are now part of the Nestle family. Nestle is actually the biggest food company in the world in revenue and is present all over the globe with corporate offices in over 100 countries.
Nestle makes really good chocolate, and I've seen their brand on water bottles before.
Nestle makes tea, and they make all kinds of
the sugar things, all the good things in life.
They make those little crunch bars that come in the blue wrappers, and I think just candy in general, and cookies. Aren't there Nestle Whole House cookies? That's all I got.
Frozen cook, I believe. It's by Nestle.
Hot chocolate. My heart.
I think Nestle makes water.
So what exactly does Nestle make? Nestle makes Nesquik, Gerber, Hot Pockets, Laffy Taffy, Campbell's Soup, Butterfingers, Carnation, Cheerios, Cookie Crisp, Eddie's, Stouffer's, Goober, Häagen-Dazs, Juicy Juice, Toll House, Kit Kat, Drumstick, Crunch, Pure Life, Perrier, Pixie Sticks, Raisinets, Runts, Push-Ups, Gobstoppers, Spree, Nescafe, Milo, Coffee Mate, Friskies, Purina Dog Food, and Lean Cuisine.
See you in the morning, you're my color of the rising sky.
We believe that leadership is not just about size, it is also about behavior. Trust, too, is about behavior, and we recognize that trust is earned only over a long period of time by consistently delivering on our promises. These objectives and behaviors are encapsulated in the simple phrase, good food, good life, a phrase that sums up our corporate ambition. Nestle's effectiveness in accomplishing its mission is reviewed on a website called Behind the Brands, which looks at food companies' friendliness towards society and the environment. Overall, Nestle received a score of 54%, the highest of all companies evaluated by the website. Nestle recognizes workers' rights and has a strong record for treating them well. Nestle performed best in the water category, due mainly to its participation in water initiatives that focus on providing clean water in countries that do not have it, and its focus on changing public policy and looking at its own supply chain and how its use of water affects the environment. The way Nestle treats its workers and cares about their water usage are a few examples of how they're making sure the impact of their globalization is positive.
The energy technology revolution. And if we can make that breakthrough, where we can get clean, green, distributed power, what you are going to see is the flattening of the world extend at an incredible clip to every rural village in India, in China, in Brazil. The world will truly become flat when IT meets ET. And when localization is in balance with globalization, what you end up with is humanization.
What is the impact? In recent years, Nestle has begun to realize the importance of shared value in its business practices. Nestle doesn't just focus on making profit for themselves, but they take care of their producers and the communities they're involved with. For example, the typical African and Latin American coffee grower is trapped in a cycle of low productivity, poor quality, and environmental degradation that limits production. Nestle helps its growers by providing advice on farming practices, guaranteeing bank loans, and helping secure important pesticides and fertilizers. By focusing on shared value, Nestle has been able to truly globalize, integrating economies, cultures, and societies across the world. Nestle is a prime example of a company that has recognized its role in the world and has taken an active role in improving it. It has proved that a key to operating profitability in a globalized world is to take care of the people that the company affects, which in the case of Nestle is almost everybody.
It affects me.
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 It affects me.